like, oh my God, they hate me. And then I realise they don't hate me. I know they don't hate me because they will clean some stuff, right? Because they know it excites me or something. They think it turns me on to watch them do chores. I really would rather they didn't. They wait till I'm relaxing, watching a bit of, I don't know, You've Been Framed or something. Just the pains of the elderly to relax me of an evening. Yeah, go on, get on the pogo stick. See how that ends. They'll wait till I'm just chilling out and then one of them will go, oh, I'm going to do the washing up. And I have to sit there and think, yeah, so am I. 5 minutes after you think you've done it. Watch them. They're just shit. They don't understand. They look at me. It's like a little lap dance. They're watching me going, yeah, can you see what I'm doing? Can you see what I'm doing? I have to go, yeah, I can see what you're doing. You're doing a baking tray when there's still wine glasses. How can you explain that to an adult who doesn't know? You can't, well, because the grease goes in and then the thing, I try and do it subtly because I don't want to, I'm the arsehole if I go, you know you're washing the baking tray. Just like the next night I'll go, oh, this Sauvignon Blanc's a bit pork and leaky. Just throw some breadcrumbs out saying, I said his wine tasted like pork and leek, but then it's me that had pork and leek toffee cheese. But I washed my baking tray. But then I washed the wine. It's my fault. I say that and they go, oh, don't buy that one again. They didn't do it, you did it. I didn't buy it because I read the label and it went, this has hints of pork and friggin' leek. Well, do you know what this wine goes well with? Mashed potato! There's some things they do, I just think there's no logic to that at all. We'll be washing up here at the sink. Right, and I've put a little thing here, it's like a bean tin, but it's got holes in it. So you put the cutlery in there, and it's all together then, you're not chasing it round, and the water comes out of the holes, so you just take it away, right? I watch them washing up, reach past this thing, they can see it, it's there. They would have to be blind in this eye and looking that way not to be able to see it. They travel the extra distance to lay the cutlery flat on the side. And I mean all the cutlery, including teaspoons, and not that way round. So that a little pool of shitty water dribbles down into the teaspoon so that it looks like it's already got soup in it. And then they walk over to the cutlery drawer and all I ask, you just put the cutlery away however you like, as long as it's forks on the left, knives in the middle, spoons on the right. Teaspoons on the bottom facing to the left, steak knives on the far left. You can't fit the steak knives in the ordinary knife rack, they're too long. It's just they have to go in there, lovely, sexy steak knives they are. Sexy jet black handle and a long serrated knife. They'll be putting it away, and they'll put some away, right? They go, oh yeah, they go in there, don't they? And then they just think, oh, bored of this. Doing it right. I'm gonna put this one in the knife rack. And then I'm gonna take the paring knife, and I'm gonna put the paring knife in there as if they look anything alike. Fat, horrible grey handle on the paring knife. No serration on the blade, little fat stubby blade, and I think, how have you done that? But the only consolation I get is it's okay, because that's the one I'm gonna kill them with. I'm gonna grab that knife and I'm gonna sneak up to their room in the middle of the night. I'm gonna go, hello, it's the fairy, and he's tooled up. I'm gonna stab you now with this steak knife. Oh, that's actually a paring knife. So you